Yet another episode at Date with DYC. Today, we have none other than Father Omar Fernandes. Come on, everybody, give him a round of applause. Come on, everyone. As most of you all know him, as the dynamic personality that he carries, this young, dynamic priest from St. Francis Xavier, Villeparle, where he's currently at. And most of us know his passion for biking, his passion for football. And today we're going to talk about the other passions that he also has, apart from being a priest. So, Father, please tell us your experience of being priest for 1 year now. Just over 1 year. And please tell us the experience of being the young, dynamic personality that you are.
So, I'm happy that you mentioned my passions of, yes, biking, yes, sports.
Yes.
There's another passion also of the priesthood, which is what compelled me to be a priest today. Funny that you mention it, because these are two things that I still hold very dear and I still incorporated in my ministry a lot, especially in youth ministry, because I mean, biking, which youth does not want to be on the road with the wind blowing in their hair, whether it's short or whether it's long? It's but football as well, because I mean, sports is always there for us to be active and for us to be healthy. And I think there's a spirituality in both of those things as well. There's this misconception that the priesthood involves something that would only be down to prayer life, the P of prayers, but these passions also can always be incorporated in your priesthood as well, which is something that I always try and incorporate every single day.
So what is your entire experience of being a priest and your interaction with different setups, like you, the elders, the senior citizen, also the ministry of widows, and what is your entire experience till date?
Well, for me, being a priest in the first place was something that, I mean, I, for one, did not envision myself being. But I was not in the youth group as such.
Yeah.
I was not in the youth group as a youth. So for me to be a priest and in charge of these ministries is something really new to me. But I find myself very comfortable with the youth ministry especially, and also the other extreme, which is the senior citizens and also the Hope and Life, the widows movement, which is something that I find gives me a lot of satisfaction.
So there is this notion that all those who are very actively involved in church are the ones who will end up becoming a priest. But if you go back and look at it, those who are actively involved in the church do not end up becoming a priest. But the ones who have not been... So a lot of mummies and daddies are now getting happy and they're looking at their brothers and saying, ah, Baba, there is some hope that is going to happen.
So I'll give these mothers and fathers further hope. I was, what do you call, an outstanding Catholic. So I was standing way outside the church, not knowing who the celebrant was, not knowing what the homily, definitely not knowing what the reading was of the day. I would just walk into church for Holy Communion and that was it. I marked my attendance for the Sunday. After that, I had a God experience, which is what most of us will have in our life. Hopefully that changes us for the better, and hopefully it's something that sticks with us and it's something that we take forward every single day of our lives.
So there is also this misconception that those who end up becoming priests did not have any girlfriends and did not have the did not have experience love with the opposite sex. So, is that again true with you or no?
What have you heard, my
friend? I've not heard anything. So, I want to hear from you.
Look, obviously there is an attraction towards the opposite sex before the priesthood.
Yeah.
And you appreciate beauty also now as a priest, obviously. The thing is, people have this idea of who you are right now as a priest. And this idea is what gets them attracted to you. But when you actually get to know the person, like, get to know me, it's another question. It's about if they actually like you that way or they just respect you for being a priest and a representative of God at the end of the day.
So we just want to like loosen this up. So tell us your life before being a priest to now and just tell us like some fun moments. So after your video, we have a lot of calls to Father Aniceto and saying that this year there has been a revolution and some 40 of them want to join the priesthood. So tell us your true story. Your true
what exactly do you want to
an inspiration to becoming a priest, your discernment story, your call story.
So, I mean, we were very involved in the church. We are three brothers. I have an identical twin and an elder brother also.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We'll come back to that later.
We'll come to that. So, growing up, our mother would always push us into the ministry. We were lectors, we were altar servers and so on. It was only during our college years that we sort of did not give enough time to the church in these ministries. So what we did was we actually gave more importance to our friends. And I would not say we strayed away from the church, but we were just regular Sunday church goers.
Sunday mass attendance, done, khatam.
And once I started working in the airlines is when I really realized that God was calling me to serve Him. It was helping out these loaders who were there on the flights, physically loading baggage and cargo. In the interactions with them, I realized there was a lot of good to be done.
Oh, really?
And as I mentioned earlier, the God experience is something that I had during my time at work itself. And that's when I decided that, yes, God is calling me and I tried to move towards
it. So this is your God experience. So Father, a lot of times people think that God's calling is you're walking in the middle of the road, the lightning strikes and this blindness and you don't know what happens and suddenly you have like a hand that comes up to you says, come join me. Like this happened to you as well?
No, actually it was quite the opposite because when I was at work, I had a small cabin near the baggage area and it was about 12 in the night. I was doing a night shift that time and I just opened the pocket Bible to read a scripture verse and then that was the third day of doing this because I had spoken to a priest about a possible vocation that I had and he recommended that I do this. And the first 2 days of reading that Bible, reading the scripture verses had no effect on me.
So you randomly just open it?
Randomly.
Okay.
And the third day when I opened it, I said, let me reflect on what I have read. So I did and I closed my eyes and just then I felt a gentle tap on my shoulder. Can you guess who that was?
Your boss.
No, it was a guy from the morning shift. He came and he asked me, he said, what are you doing sleeping in the cabin? I said, no, I just closed my eyes for a few minutes. What are you doing here so early? And I looked at the watch and I realized it was 2 o'clock. So I spent 2 hours of deep meditation. Ooh. For a guy who's standing outside church. It was something that really shocked me. And then from there on, I started having this God experience and discerning.
Then you continued with the entire process of reading the Bible. Yeah. How many days was this?
Reading the Bible per se, I found other spiritual activities, spiritual exercises that I would engage in, which helped me discern better whether I was actually called to the priesthood or not.
So, I've heard this word a lot of times and everybody keeps talking about this, but I've never understood the meaning. What is discernment?
Well, everybody has a vocation to either a career, a family, and all other avenues. Discernment would be what is God calling you to do specifically? You being a unique person, you being made in the image and likeness of God. So you have a purpose to serve. Discerning would be, what is that purpose God has called me for?
Okay. Oh, that is... So, today so I
even,
have learned...
Even within the priesthood, there would be various ministries that you're specified to.
So youth or...
It's a constant movement of discerning.
So, okay. So the... Okay. So basically join the youth group or... Go ahead. Join the sector
scripture,
which works in the youth or scriptures or... So, okay. Understood. So today I've learned, finally learned what the meaning of discernment is. But coming back to you have an identical twin. So have you been misunderstood for somebody else or for your identical twin brother? And I'm sure he has been misunderstood for you.
The thing is, he is a lot more famous or popular than me. A lot more because he has about 100 odd thousand subscribers on YouTube.
Ooh.
So very often I get mistaken for him. And then they see the long hair and then they realize, okay, this So when he gets mistaken for me, I remember there was one incident in particular during the Easter Vigil Mass, where he was at Mount Carmel's, our home parish, and I was in Thane. And someone came up to him and said, "Father, nice to meet you. How are you doing? Can you give me your blessing?"
Okay.
And he stretched out his hand and blessed the person. Now, there's a good understanding, a good reason behind that. He said, if I would explain myself to the person, it would take about 2 to 3 minutes. But if I bless the person, I'd have a lot more time to go back and go to the party that I was supposed to attend. So it is.
Yeah, but I think, so here in India or in Mumbai, we ask the priest or the nuns and all to bless us. But I remember when I had gone for World Youth Day in Krakow, mm-hmm. we used to, like, we have this habit, right? We go come and say, "Father, bless me," mm-hmm. or "Sister, bless me." We should do the same thing over there. And in return, once they bless us, they will tell us, "Okay, now you bless me." But we were like, "But we are not allowed, like, not allowed to bless you." And they would be like, "No, everyone is like, everybody as an individual has the right to bless each other." So then we had asked them for blessing, so they also, then after that, we had to bless them.
Mm-hmm.
So does that happen everywhere else, or is that a good gesture? Or
let me ask you a question, Melroy. Are you a priest?
No.
Yes, you are. There are two priesthoods, the common priesthood and the ministerial priesthood.
Okay.
The ministerial priesthood would be us, the ordained ministers, the clergy. The common priesthood would be the laity, the lay people. And both of us have roles to play in the church.
Oh.
It's not to say that one is more important than the other. We complement each other. So when a religious or a priest would ask you for a blessing, it would be for a blessing based on your common priesthood.
Okay.
And your duty to proclaim the gospels with your life.
So mom, you heard it. I'm a priest. Now all your prayers have been answered. Now you have to stop praying for anything for me, okay? Done. Now it is all done.
Tell your mom she's a priest as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, will, yeah.
So that's what Father. So that's how it we like your final blessing says, go out and proclaim the word of the Lord. Mm-hmm. So that's how we are also supposed to.
That's your duty.
That's our duty. Okay. So now tell me some more incidents about you being mistaken for somebody else.
There was one very funny moment. Both of us play football. He favors his left foot. I favor my right foot. So okay. We play on in midfield on either wing. Yeah. So. There was one match, it was a final at Parel, the MDFA ground, where he started on the left side, I started on the right side. And he had a very incredible game because he gave two assists and, no, he did not score. He gave two assists and we ended up winning that match 3-0. After the match, a reporter came to interview him and he said, "You played so well, one time I saw you on the left side and one time I saw you on the right side. Are there professional clubs actually looking to sign you?" And he said, "No, meet my twin brother, you saw him." So it happens a lot, yeah.
So that time you had short hair or he had long hair? Or
no, I've always had short hair. It's only after the priesthood that I decided to change my look because there were confusions that would ruin my reputation. So, I remember somebody calling home, or my mother told me rather, and she said, the person said, "Your son who is going to become a priest is outside a club around here in Bandra at around 11:30 in the night." And then she called me up and I was deep in my sleep. I got up and I said, "What happened?" She said, "Somebody is complaining that you are there." I said, "No, I assure you." I sent her a picture of my room and I said, "I'm in the seminary." So she said, "Try and differentiate yourself from your twin. Now it would help." So I decided to grow my hair because he would always copy my look and he'll claim otherwise. So when I grew a beard, he grew a beard. Just so I was like his guinea pig to see if it looks okay. Then he would try it out the same time. The only thing that he can't do is grow his hair because he works in a professional organization, which
so
does
he
not
cannot
allow him.
Allow.
So this is the only way out.
So Ogden, he's told us that you've copied him, and now when we have a conversation with you, you'll say, "I think next time we should have a conversation with both."
No,
of
there's
us.
No need. I've told you the truth.
We've seen your love for biking, and we also want to see your love for music, which we will see in the latter part of this episode. But before that, did you ever think that you would sit on the chair and I would be interviewing you?
Never.
Damn it. So a priest interviewing another priest. You proclaimed I'm a priest today.
Yeah. But I always thought Ivan would put me in an uncomfortable situation and make a girl interview me. I'm happy to.
So has he done that before?
He's put me in various uncomfortable situations, but it's okay. I forgive him. I have to forgive.
So now that you're talking about a girl, how are you managing with so much of fan following and female attention that you get now?
people say I take advantage of them, and I would say yes. So if the Cardinal is watching this, yes, Cardinal, I take advantage of them. I direct them towards the youth group and keep them in important positions over there.
So all those who are watching the video, please watch the entire video. Don't watch in bits and pieces and put any one of us in trouble, okay? And if you're doing that... Okay, so what we do is, in our episode, we have a fun selfie that we take. And we want to introduce you also to this fun character in our episode. So let's go and take a selfie with him.
Come on.
Let's do this. So Father, we'll take a selfie with our dost, our host, and our very own Jesus Christ.
Sure.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. So we are back with our game session, and today we're gonna have who breaks first. So the rules are very simple. I will crack a joke, you will crack a joke. If either of us break or laugh, so we pick up a chit, and from this lovely juices that we have, that the DYC is prepared for us, so we have to drink it. Ready?
Let's start, come on.
Okay, you wanna go first?
No,
you go first.
Ladies first.
Go first.
Okay.
Nani? I'll
start simple. Wait.
Don't read my show.
So I'll start off very simple to give you a fighting chance, okay? I have a wife, Melroy, and she says that I have only two faults. One is I don't complete my sentences and
he's making me smile.
That's it, no?
Cucumber. This is cucumber.
This?
This. This is cucumber. Have you finished the entire thing?
In one. He has to down it, no? No, don't down it. I might have to drink something. It's good. It's healthy. You can see the...
Some sugar.
Muscles building up already. It's healthy. So,
okay. Go. Next, me. Knock, knock.
Who's that?
Nana.
Nana who?
Nana your business! Damn! You didn't break only.
Okay.
So I have to drink?
I mean, if you don't make the other person laugh, this game will go a lot faster if you follow that rule. Karela!
Oh, damn it!
No, my turn. You have to gulp it down. It's alright, come on.
Wait.
My turn, no? Is it? My turn, okay. Don't laugh. Huh? So, you know what a gender reveal party is? So if I'm asking you honestly, it's not a joke.
No, I don't know.
So a gender reveal party is when a couple is expecting a child, and they announce what the gender of the child will be by probably releasing blue ribbons or something like that. Okay. Oh, if you do not know it, I do not know if you'll laugh at this joke. So a man went for a gender reveal party and he got thrown out of the place. When he came out, he started screaming, "Why am I the only naked person in this gender reveal party?"
Wake up!
Carrot, huh?
Oh, damn. What a love one.
Cheers. It's your turn.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Tank.
Tank.
You're welcome! He's not laughing. He smiled. Okay, damn.
The second Karela, FYI.
Can I change it with something else?
No, don't put that back in.
No, put back in. Yeah, but did the other change? Okay. Could be enough.
Want to change again?
Yeah. This is better than the Karela at least.
Is this a regular feature? I mean, is this the same game you play with all the other guests?
No, they're different games. Okay, that's wrong. I'm not gonna break.
Okay, the final one. We are in the pandemic, right? Okay, and earlier it was said that dogs could also carry the virus and we would contact it from dogs. But the WHO, the World Health Organization, said that the dogs are not actual carriers of the COVID-19. So to be clear, Melroy, who let the dogs out of the quarantine? Smile. I know which one to avoid because you left the...
That was a night joke.
I had to... Put it in. Good part got left. Alright. We still have one more round?
My last question.
Beetroots. So if you lose this, you just have this directly. Okay? Again, rather.
What is ugly and who thinks he's smart and has an internet?
I don't know.
You! Damn, he's not laughing on his own jokes also now. Don't offer.
No, just like that, no? I mean, you know what he has traced with this one. So I think This was mistaken for.
Beetroot.
So you've tasted all, no? So we can stop the game.
So that was a fun game.
Nice. You're a good sport,
huh? It's good game. So, Father, we've had an amazing session with you today.
Thank you, I have.
And this lovely chat show that we've had and the amazing game that we played, and you really cracked us with some amazing jokes that I had to end up drinking all of those. So, we have a small token of appreciation for you. This is
our small token
of appreciation.
Thank you so much.
And we have a big token of appreciation as well. And this is a big token of appreciation. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you, my
boy. Thank you and gracing us with your presence.
Thanks a lot.
And for all you guys, do come back again next week. Same time, same place on our YouTube channel. That's DYC Mumbai. Till then, goodbye. So, wait. Don't go anywhere. We have live nights with DYC. That is going to follow, and we have none other than Father Omar who's going to be performing some amazing tracks for us. So stay tuned.
This is a song by the band Oasis. It's called Don't Look Back in Anger. Slip inside the eye of your mind. Don't you know you might find a better place to play? You said that you'd never been, but all the things that you've seen slowly fade away. I'm gonna start a revolution from my bed, 'cause you said the brains I had went to my head. Step outside for summer times in bloom. Stand up beside the fireplace. Take that look from off your face. You ain't never gonna burn my heart out. And so Sally can wait. She knows it's too late as she's walking on by. Soul slides away, but don't look back in anger. Heard you say, take me to the place where you go, where nobody knows if it's night or day. And please don't put your life in the hands of a rock and roll band. Throw it all. Start a revolution from my bed, 'cause you said the brains I had went to my head. Step outside 'cause summer time's in bloom.
stand up beside the fireplace. Take that look from off your face. You ain't ever gonna burn my heart out. And so Sally can wait. She knows it's too late as she's walking on by. Her soul slides away. But don't look back in anger. Don't look back in anger. Heard you say.
You might have heard it, it's John Mayer's Daughters.
Next episode.